Hey guys, it's Mike, and here we have pyramid power. This is a super easy way to do a few very interesting things, and I want to warn you that some of the things in this video could quite possibly kill somebody because of electrical shocks, so you should always take every precaution when working with high voltage electrical items such as this. So this is actually a proven science. The guy that I know of that actually did something similar almost killed himself with at least a 20 kilovolt shock. And he didn't even use a tinfoil covered pyramid. He just had a spiral copper wire going counterclockwise all the way up to the apex. And yeah, it scared him so much he decided just to stop experimenting with it. But don't give up like he did, because you can really do some amazing things with something like this, not just in free power generation, but you'll notice something else extremely interesting about what happens under the pyramid itself. So I found out not long ago, and I always had a theory on this, but this actually verified it, where there's a tunnel underneath a pyramid down in Mexico. And they found out that the clay balls that were rich in ferrite oxides, so they get clay from the river and the clay wasn't clean, it had a lot of ferrite oxide in it, they grew into crystals of fool's gold, basically iron pyrite, and really good looking iron pyrite crystals too. They were just perfectly formed, and lots of these things. So who knows how long they sat down there before they actually did that, but that pyramid there was just a simple dielectric pyramid. It wasn't even metal coated. So if you put together a metal coated pyramid, you could find out that in just a few hours, you could grow some really interesting, neat and beautiful crystals at the base of this thing. So one thing I only learned about recently is there's a very simple formula on YouTube on how to grow opal. So if you take that very simple recipe to grow opal, and opal's extremely, you know, expensive. You look on eBay and look to see what opal costs. You might find that it's not cheap. So if you can actually successfully grow opal below one of these things, then go ahead, because instead of waiting 2 or 6 months for your opal to grow from that solution, then you could grow it a lot faster, maybe possibly in just a few days, maybe in 24 hours. And it's just another neat thing I wanted to mention before I get into the function of this whole thing. Okay, so another thing is graphene. So CO2 gas will, at 1900 degrees, on a superconductive surface, form a perfect layer of diamond. Below that, it will continue growing carbon structure, and the next one is graphene. So with just a weak field, you can grow graphene, and that doesn't necessarily mean that the pyramid is going to grow graphene very well. It's just an idea. It's another one of the experiments you could try with this thing. And graphene is one of those things you could, again, make a lot of money with really fast, because the cost of making graphene is really steep. But with something like this, you could make it so fast that you could make your own graphene capacitors enough to basically rival all the batteries in a Tesla Model S and have something that would work a lot longer for a lot cheaper, and never have problems with burning up, starting fires, exploding, things like that. The problems with lithium batteries are endless. And to see what's happened to kids around the world having to mine some of the materials for these batteries, it's just sickening. So I'd love to see that come to an end right away. So start out here with your iron mass. You're going to take an iron mass and bury it in the ground. It's going to have to be where the ground is wet. If you're in an area that doesn't have iron, then you'll have water at some point, right? Hopefully. So bury your iron mass in the ground. Otherwise, you end up with another much more serious problem than electrocution. And that is the disappearing pyramid. So you may not believe it, but if you break spark gap on a pyramid that's not grounded, it will end up dematerializing in space and disappearing. And as it disappears, it forms its own ionosphere. That ionosphere is just what it sounds like. It's an ionic bubble. And inside that ionic bubble, time suddenly moves a little bit slower. That means there is a transition point between the inside and the outside of the pyramid. And if it suddenly turns on and your hand is on the inside with the rest of you on the outside of that bubble, what's going to happen is the pyramid will disappear with your hand. You'll never see it again, and you'll never get your hand back. Okay, so that's another danger besides electrocution. So do be aware. The grounding material should be as high as you can get because the grounding, the more the better. So you run that up with rebar through three copper plates. You just solder each layer on, separated by wood or something that's not going to melt if it gets hot. You run that up to where you see those little two little spears there. That's a spark gap. So you don't have to have your spark gap in here. It would actually be ideal to have that outside of the pyramid. And you run that outside the pyramid, and you can not just have two wires to control the spark gap, but you can have one of those wires run as a coil around a transformer core. That means that you're able to gather free power and run that into your electric heater or electric stove or whatever you want to run off of this thing. It's not going to be 60 hertz, but it's going to be okay. You know, you'll have something you can run things with or just run a power head with, because you could use that frequency to run a motor, and the motor could rotate the power head. So it's unlimited free energy, and it's a massive amount from a small space. So from here up, you're not using rebar anymore. You got brass or copper. And then here I use on mine 9 AWG copper wires connected to some 2x4s, you wrap tin foil, and then on the very top, you can't have tin foil, you need to have like a copper sheet. So use like a 1 mil copper sheet folded to a sharp point on the apex. And the only maintenance you really have to do on this is maintaining your spark gap anode electrodes and the apex, which will wear off from heat. That's where zero point folds. And it folds as a result of the three-phase dynamo effect of these three plates in repulsion to the collapsing wave of the charge wave that comes out of Earth. So the pyramid itself is going to be a sympathetic wave. We know that Earth spits out a massively negative bias wave. So if you catch that with something that can go a little bit out of phase from it, so you've got a tinfoil pyramid, for example, which is a great parachute to that. It'll catch it quite well. Then you're forming what's called a sympathetic wave. So it's in sync, yet it's out of phase. And now your copper plates are going to give you a continued fractal on top of that. And that allows you to collapse not just a single wave, but multiple waves. And when multiple waves collapse, in sync, yet out of phase, they don't do anything originally. But if they do it more than once and you lose energy off the apex, then especially with a higher spark gap, the more spark gap, the better, you'll end up gaining inductive energy from this whole circuit because it's wasting energy up here. So it's spitting out negative ions here, and it's spilling off positive ions that are spinning around and flowing down off the edges of the pyramid, which, by the way, don't let it ground. You're going to have to use rock or something down here to make sure it doesn't ground the edges out. And that's really all there is to it. It's really that simple. If you were to build one of these just 5 feet wide, you could probably run everything in your house with it. And Again, that all depends on other factors like how much copper plate, the spacing, the mass you have buried in the ground. But that's pretty much it. As far as getting crazy and using this thing to purposely dematerialize and go fly off somewhere, all I can say is be careful. Because it's a real possibility that you really could dematerialize too far if you break spark gap too much, and that means space-time itself is slowing down so much inside that the matter in your body will no longer be effectively in existence. It will literally melt away. Carbon. Carbon, for example, will become a liquid in the fourth dimension, or the fourth density of space, what I call boson format 4. And I think that's it. It's time for me to eat a donut and end this video. All I can say is experiment away and you'll find out what this thing is really capable of, and it is not something that you should take lightly. Mike out.